This is a fictional high-speed train I made for a fictional American bullet train route I'm working on. This replaces the AM500 train I made in the past. The reason being because I recently learned a lot of new techniques when making the Amtrak AEM7, and I wanted the train to better reflect what I'm currently capable of doing. To be honest, the original train wasn't all that great. It was horribly boxy and not very aerodynamic in appearance. It didn't have an animated pantograph, and the front wasn't very logo friendly, so it was very difficult to put a logo on it. Also, the original destination sign was too simple. This one is a lot better. On the side of the train, it says that it was manufactured by Nippon Sharyo, and that it has been dubbed the 4000 series. There's a glow-in-the-dark logo in the front, and it's got directional headlights and taillights. The locomotive and passenger cars can hold up to 66 passengers. The first-class coaches and cafe cars will probably hold less when I actually get around to making those. There's a very large and spacious vestibule inside the train. I actually designed the train after the height of an autorack train car so that it could be as roomy as possible. There's a destination sign inside the train as well, and just like the one on the outside, it can display up to 4 lines of text. There's a doorway that leads to the cab and one that leads to the vestibules. The doorway that leads to the cab can only be opened by railroad staff, though. By the way, when making the previous train, someone complained that in real life, the windows have to be straight pieces of glass and they can't be curved, so I fixed that on this one. They're now made out of straight panes of glass, as required by the Federal Railway Administration, and they're also bulletproof. The passenger windows as well. As you can see, the seats have way better detailing than before. Earlier, they were just one texture and they were rectangular. They didn't have any special detail in them at all in the beginning, but I've added a lot more detail and color to them. I've also noticed that in the original train, since I used the same texture for everything inside the train, everything sort of blended together, and it was very difficult to see one detail against another one, so I put special effort in making sure every single thing inside the train is a different texture than every single other thing, so it's easier to make out exactly what you're looking at. The floor of the vestibule is illuminated with LEDs. The red line indicates where the gap is between the two cars and where it's recommended you step over when going from one car to the other. There are green lights on the sides of the doors that change red when the doors are opening to let the driver know not to proceed yet. However, it seems like glass cannot change the color of light in this game, so I'm gonna have to come up with a better way to do this, because what I have right now is a white light inside a green tinted glass, and there's also a red tinted glass above it. The white light's supposed to move inside the red lens to change it to red, but that doesn't seem to be working. Also, there's a vent on the top of the train to allow hot air to escape. I made custom wheels for this train. For the other one, I was just using wheels that I found on the download station, but these are actually custom built for the train. As you can see, this train is a lot bigger than conventional trains. That is because in the United States, a common complaint about passenger trains is that they're too cramped, so I decided to make this train as large as physically possible so that I could make it as roomy as possible inside. The train is actually a little bit wider than normal trains. As you can see, this train is more reflective than the original high-speed train that I made earlier. As you can see, the logo glows in the dark. As well as the words American Bullet Train on the side. Sadly, there still doesn't appear to be a way to illuminate the passengers at night. Also, the emergency windows glow in the dark too, so that it will be easier for someone to see where they are in an emergency. The windows are marked with white LEDs in the trim, but the emergency windows are marked with red LEDs so you can tell them apart. There's also a sign pointing to the emergency windows as well. This time I have a front and rear power car. The rear power car has its pantograph attachments reversed so that when the rear pantograph on the front power car is raised, the front one on the rear pantograph will be raised. That way, the correct facing one will always be raised on both locomotives. I also made the train a lot less bouncy than the original so that it'll stop potentially damaging the catenary lines. I gave the train the Amtrak Avelia Liberty horn. I'm gonna uncouple the locomotives real quick to show you something. In Trainz 2006, I tried coupling a locomotive with the pantograph raised to one that had the pantograph lowered to see what would happen, and it caused the trains to derail, so I'm gonna do that here just to see what would happen. Oh, it looks like it just automatically raises the same one that the locomotive has. I guess they fixed that glitch since then. I gave the locomotive and the passenger cars that I'm still working on knuckle couplers so that they can be attached to regular trains if you wanted to. Though, they wouldn't really be that compatible because they're going to be a lot wider than regular train cars. There are three headlights on the top and two on either side below the cab, and below that are two flashing ditch lights. There are also tail lights that come on if you're facing the other way. Inspiration for where to place the head and tail lights actually comes from me searching a futuristic high-speed train in Google Images and looking at the way the headlights were oriented on some of the fictional ones. I basically picked the design that I thought looked the best. There are two tail lights on the top, and there are four on the bottom. I don't know how to make cabs yet, but this is how I envisioned a futuristic cab would look. All of the buttons, levers, and switches have been replaced by touchscreen. on the top are digital displays. I probably should have changed the angle that you're looking at the screen from though, because it looks a little bit difficult to see from this angle. This is an Amtrak American Bullet Train service to Boston South Station.
Caution! The doors are about to close.
A chime will play to let the driver know that the doors have successfully closed and it's safe to proceed. By the way, for the sound of the door sliding, I use the sliding door in my back patio. This is an Amtrak American Bullet Train service to Boston South Station. Again, this light's supposed to change color, but the glass isn't really capable of doing that in this game. This is an Amtrak American Bullet Train service to Boston South Station.
The doors are about to close.
This is an Amtrak American Bullet Train service to Boston South Station.
Caution! The doors are about to close. This
The emergency windows have levers on them that can be rotated to unlock the windows so they can be pushed open. You know, that rocket cow that scientists managed to grow is actually available for download, but I couldn't get it to work in this game because it's faulty, so sadly I haven't been able to look at it. Still curious how a rocket cow could benefit society though. The emergency windows have some text on them that say emergency exit. Use lever to unlock the window. This is an Amtrak American bullet train service to Boston South Station.
Caution! The doors are about to close. This is an Amtrak American bullet train service to Boston South Station. Caution! The doors are about to close.
okay to proceed. By the way, the touchscreen on this train will be far less sensitive than the touchscreen on a cell phone. For example, on my cell phone, sometimes it reads a previous fingerprint as me constantly trying to scroll down or constantly trying to zoom in. But I came up with a failsafe for that on this train. There will be a camera mounted above the touchscreen that looks for your finger trying to push a button or move a switch. And if it doesn't see your finger, then it won't read the fingerprint as you're trying to press something. In other words, it looks for your finger and the fingerprint at the same time, and if it only detects one, then it won't count as a motion. This will prevent it accidentally pushing buttons you didn't press. It wasn't supposed to stop that fast. In fact, this is one thing I never quite understood about how the game handles mass, because I gave it the same mass that the Shinkansen has, but for some reason it still behaves differently.
This is an Amtrak American Bullet Train service to Boston South Station.
Caution! The doors are about to close.
This.
Here's a close-up of the wheels in motion. People with epilepsy or risk of seizures may want to look away. Oh, by the way, interesting fact about the running numbers. Originally, they were just going to be numbers that light up at night, but when making one of them, I accidentally painted a blue square around it, and I thought, you know what? That actually looks better. So I ended up doing that for the rest of the numbers as well.